Hey guys, it's Chika. 皆さんこんにちは、チカです。So I am in an office building right now. 今オフィスのロビーで drinking a flat white. And I've got a special video for you guys today. 今日はメルボルンにある IT 企業にお邪魔させていただきます。以前も会社見学的な動画アップした時にもっとこういうの見たいという方が多かったので、Here you go! なかなか会社の中を詳しく見るってできないんですけれど、今日はなんとチカ友の方が働いている会社なんです。先日メルボルンでミートアップをした時に、メルミートという日本人のコミュニティの方々にお手伝いしていただいて、その中のゆかさんという方がこっちの IT 企業で働いているということで、なんか見せてもらえないですかねというお話をしてたら、社長から OK をいただいたみたいです。 Yellowfin International という会社なんですけれど、企業向けのビジネスインテリジェンスだったりレポーティング、あと分析アナリティクスのソフトウェアを開発している会社です。私たちも日々オーストラリアのオフィス街を歩いてて感じるのが、すごくこっちの人たちはオンとオフがはっきりしていて、楽しく働いて楽しくプライベートを過ごしているイメージを持っています。実際仕事に対してどんな考え方を持っているのかとか、まあ、仕事をしているオフィスの中ってどんな感じなのかっていうのを皆さんとシェアできればなと思います。 So let's go meet everyone. I've got my flat white with me. I think this is a must before going to work. Feeling like a businesswoman today. Alright, じゃあ行きましょう。 Yellowfin!
こんにちは。
こんにちは。よろしくお願いします。ちかとものゆかさんです。
よろしくお願いします。
いろいろと調整してくださって、社長の OK もいただけて、
はい、みんなやる気満々です。
46階なんですけど、すごい景色すごいですね、眺めが。
Oh my gosh, look at this view.
あ、社長さんですよね、グレンさん。
Hi,
hello,
I'm Chika.
Chika, Glenn.
Thank you for letting us come here today.
It's a pleasure. Enjoying the view?
Yeah.Very mesmerized by the view. But it's starting to get really cold. So
it is cooling down. Yeah. It's autumn. But it doesn't get as cold as Japan.
You've been to Japan quite a few times, I heard.
40 times, I think.
Yuka told us you go to Japan more than she does.
That's true.
Both work and pleasure?
A little bit. Mostly work.
Mostly
but
work.
But work's pretty good.
Yeah, looks like it. Well, we're just going to be filming and then we'll probably take a minute.out of the day、
yeah.
to talk to you a little、oh, bit more.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Done. Looking forward to it.
この真ん中のあたりが開発のチームですね。
何人ぐらいいらっしゃるんですか、会社。
今全部で60人ぐらいかな、はい。私が4年前にここに来た時はこの半分以下ぐらいしか社員がいなかったので、もう本当ぐんと。
この椅子座る人いるんですか。個人的に気になるアイテム。
パワーナップする人もたまにいますね。
あ、ちょっと危ない。
ね、この景色見ながら
ね、ちょっと休憩しますみたいな。 Ooh, this is very comfortable.
Hi, I'm the CEO and co-founder of Yellowfin, Glenn Raby. Apart from data, which is one of my passions, I do love to cook, love food, so that's my weekend, it's pretty much cooking.
Justin Hewitt, Chief Operating Officer and co-founder.I'm hobby rich, but it's mostly probably surfing and skiing.
We build analytics software, and that's used by a whole range of organizations to help to analyze their data and to understand their business better, from large multinationals through to large software vendors who embed our product in theirs and who provide analytics to their customers. And we've got offices in the UK, in Japan, in the US, and here as well.
これパワーナップできるわ。あのお猿さんが好きなやつだよ。ぶどう。もう袋ごと持ってきてる。玄米茶がある。結構寒くなるんですか。
すごい寒いんですよ。で、私しか寒がらないので一回も社長に笑われましたもん。これ使って普通に仕事してたら床寝る時間じゃない
あ、みんなミーティングから戻ってこられたんですね。結構もうインターナショナルですね、やっぱり。
そうですね、はい。まあ、オーストラリア自体が、まあ、移民の国なので。
日本人はゆかさんだけ。
私だけです。斉藤由香です。
由香さんは5年前にオーストラリアに来ました。日本で働いていた環境が辛くなり、転職を考えていた際に大学時代の旅行で興味を持ったオーストラリアに行くことを決めました。
すごいゆったりと日本と全然違うっていうのがあったので、行くんだったらこういうとこがいいなっていうのをずっと思ってて。
ゆかさんは今メルボルン本社と日本支社の架け橋となり、必要なセールスやマーケティング資料の翻訳を主にされています。日本の働き方との一番の違いを聞いてみました。
自分のタスクをこなしてれば帰ってもいいみたいな
やることやってれば
そうですね。私生活と仕事の切り分けっていうのがパッキリしてるので、ちゃんと成果が上がってれば 全然問題ないっていう、okay. 自分の裁量に任せて全部やらせてもらえる、まあ、そこですね。一番大きいのは全然フレキシブルですよね。これはここが上がります。
疲れますよね。
疲れます、ね、1日ずっとなんで。こっちのいいところは疲れたらみんなすぐ休憩に行きますね。
そんな無理しなくていい。そんなゆかさんが今回いろんな方の働き方について聞けるように社員の方とインタビューの時間を調整してくれました。
Hi! Good, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, I'm Lauren.
こちらは8歳と11歳のお子さんがいらっしゃるローレンさん。現在 Yellowfin でパートタイムで経理のお仕事をされています。
What I suppose attracted me to the job here was flexible working hours、yeah. that I can drop them off at school, come to work, get home in time to pick them up from school.
オーストラリアにはスクールバスの文化がないらしく、子どもたちが小さいうちには特にフレキシブルな働き方が必要みたいです。
Is there any frustrations or stress trying to juggle both?
A little bit. So at the moment in Australia it's school holidays.、
Mm.
So there's no school.
What do you do?
And these holidays have been a bit of a juggle between, you know, grandparents. My husband worked from home. Today I have a babysitter、
oh, okay.
with them.
But you're able to bring them here if you wanted to?
I have.Yes, I have brought them here.
オーストラリアでは会社に子供を連れてくる方も少なくないみたいです。
普通によくあることなんです。
よくあることです。
When you have a babysitter, is that someone in the neighborhood or?
Yes, so the babysitter today is actually one of the primary school teacher's daughters who is a university student、oh. and she babysits for us on a semi-regular basis.
That's nice、so、to have.
It is. It's good to have someone you know and trust and、mm-hmm. the children enjoy her coming because it's, you know, it's fun. Someone young and fun.
働くママに対するオーストラリア企業の意識について聞いてみました。
I think employers on the whole are becoming a lot more flexible for working mums. They realize the value that they bring to a workplace.、
Right.
There's been studies aboutthe productivity of a working mum and how much higher that is、
yeah.
or can be because, you know, we're here. We've got to leave at a certain time, so we've got to fit all the work in before、
right.
we leave.
And you're more focused, I guess, in
yeah, I think it's becoming more accepted that women want to be able to have their family,、mm-hmm. have a career、
yeah.
and be able to manage both. And that's definitely becoming, I think, a higher priority for employers.
Do you ever feel, like, guilty for leaving early?、
Yeah. Sometimes, because I know I have to leave at 2:45、yeah. so I can get downstairs to the train、mm. if I miss the train I miss school pickup、
right.
which has happened.
Oh, it has happened.
It has happened.
Oh, no.
Or if my train has been cancelled、
yeah.
which、wouldn't be a thing that happens in Japan.
Yeah, that's
but here,
true.
It can happen. So yeah, oh, look, I do because everyone else is still working.
Yeah.
But、mm. no one makes, it's me.
Right.
No one else makes me feel that way.、
Mm.
My team are very mindful that they know、mm-hmm. this is the time frame I have. They don't put any undue pressure on me、
right.
to take on more than I canhandle.
You work every day though, or Monday through Friday?
No,
you're here?
I work Tuesday, Wednesday and Friday, so I have Thursdays off.
Okay.
And then on Wednesdays I do work a full 8-hour day、
okay.
and my husband works from home、
okay.
and so he does school drop off and pick up and takes them to swimming lessons after school.
It's common here for dads to...
Yeah, it's becoming more so.
More so.
Yes.
Yeah.
And it's changing here because a lot of times dads get accolade for doing the stuff that...Mums do、
oh.
every day without thinking about it.
So that、
oh,
happens
isn't
here
he a
too.
Good, isn't he great? Oh, look at him taking them to swimming. It's like, yes, but for the 10 years before that, I was taking them to swimming.
Right.
It is definitely a changing thing. It's a lot more common now to see, you know, dads doing school drop off and、mm-hmm. pick up and at the activities.
You work and then you go pick up and、mm-hmm. then you have to do house stuff.
Yes.
I mean, what are、yeah. the things that you're kind of like, oh, I can cut back here?
Yeah, yeah. Look, so I'm lucky enough that I have.A cleaner, someone comes to clean、mm-hmm. house. So that's something I don't have to worry about.、
Mm. Is that also common?
Certainly within my social circle,、
mm-hmm.
it's a common thing when、yeah. you're both parents are working. You know, if you're working during the week, you don't want to spend your weekend
cleaning
the house.
That, yeah,
you could be relaxing or
yeah,
you
hanging
know,
out with the kids,
hanging out with the kids, or taking them to their activities. And I think on the whole, mothers are learning to put less pressure on themselves,、
mm-hmm.
and you don't have to do everything and do it perfectly. And you know what? Sometimes if you haveToast for dinner, that's okay. You can't be cooking a gourmet meal、
yeah.
every night of the week.
インタビュー後、雑談でお互いの夏の予定について話してたら
Over the summer, we're going to go to the States because、
oh.
my parents live there.
Oh, fantastic. I'm going、for the summer.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So my husband、is taking long service leave from work. So once you've worked for 15 years at the same company, you get 13 weeks paid leave.
Three months.
So we're taking most of that. And so I've got very generously leave from my
job. Oh, so you're able to take that off too?
Yeah, yeah. Yes. I don't have any annual leave, so it's unpaid leave for me.
Oh, okay. But yeah. they're flexible
yeah.
with that.
Yeah.
What are they going to do while you're gone? They'll figure it out?
You know, yeah. Work it out. <It'll be> fine. I mean, I think they'll probably get someone in to cover for me so that the rest of the team doesn't have extra work.
Right. But you don't hesitate to ask and just see.
Yeah. No. Got to take those opportunities when they come up, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. Working for somewhere flexible helps with that.
Thank you. It was nice talking to you.
Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of your stay here.
Yeah.
日本だとその、まあ、私もそうでしたけど、辞めるってなるともう引き継ぎこれぐらい前から準備してこれやんなきゃ、mm-hmm. やんなきゃってなるけど、もうじゃあ辞めました。えみたいな。でも次新しい人すぐ来ましたって言っても、うん、なその入れ替わっていくことが当たり前っていう考え方で、まあ、なんか社会の仕組みの違いですよね、考え方。
うん、次は新卒で入られたデベロッパーのリアンさん。
Likewise, I'm Leanne.
新卒の働き方について聞いてみました。
So I studied computer science and I chose that because I've had an interest in technology from a young age. It actually started with video games, but then I thought that maybe I should look into other areas where there's more jobs. And through my course at uni, I found that I liked web development, which is what I do here. So yeah, I make the web pages work good.
How long have you been here?
I've been here for almost 3 months now.
3 months? Okay, yeah. So you're still quite new.
Still quite new, yeah. I'm still my probation period.
Mm-hmm. And how long is that?
That's 6 months.
6 months.
Yeah. But in terms of a graduate position, they understand that, you know, I'm still a graduate. I have learnt the theory, but not necessarily had much time to put it into like a lot of practice. Normally they would like pair you up with say like a senior developer for a little while so they can kind of show you how they go about stuff. They don't put too much pressure on me, which I think is really important.
What time do you get off work?
I usually finish around 5 o'clock.
And then do you work at home as well?
Not afterwards, but I do have the option to work from home if needed.
You don't work outside of the working hours?
No.
Female developers, I know, are starting to...
It is a male-dominated field.
Yeah. How is that? Do you honestly, even think about it?
There's actually quite a lot of female developers here as well.
Yeah, I noticed that. Yeah.
Girls are being told that, you know, they can do this. There's nothing really stopping them apart from their own interests. And they shouldn't let the fact that it is currently male-dominated still affect them.
And so you're obviously not letting it.
Nope.
Yeah.
I never will.
Yeah. Thank you. It's Friday. Do you get to leave a little early today or no?
We normally finish up about... like 4 o'clock and then we might have drinks and stuff and people just are free to leave as they please.
Only a couple hours. Yeah.
Just lunchtime as well.
Oh yeah, that's true. Now we are going to lunch with everyone.
I'm Dan.
Oh, yeah.
How are you doing?
Nice,
nice to meet you. How's it all going? So
yeah,
far?
It's good.
Yeah.
Lots of filming.
Good.
Our batteries are running low already. Yeah.
What's been your highlight so far the last couple of months?
We have a daughter, a 10-month-old daughter. She's in daycare, so that's something new for us.
Oh, yes.
You know.
Boys are in daycare for 3 days a week. So.
Pick up sometimes?
I do the drop-offs.
Oh, you do the drop-offs.
My wife does the pick-ups.
Okay.
We rotate it. We've got a bit of a system, which works pretty well.
So. Yeah, so your wife works as well?
She does work, yeah. She works full-time too, so it's...
juggling things.
It's a lot of juggling at the moment, but we get through it.
Yeah. In Japan, it's more of the moms that are expected to do... Yeah.
Is that changing a bit more these days, or is it still?
So we have a word called ikumen, which means dads that take care of their kids.
Okay.
Which sounds a little odd that we have that sort of word because it's like
it's your dad. You should.
Yeah. Thank you. ランチには他にもいろんな方が参加してくださって、フランクにたくさんのお話をしてくれました。ローレンさんがお話ししていた長期休暇について CEO のグレンさんに聞いてみたら。
Is that hard to deal with as an employer?
It's not great. Because typically the people who've been there for that long are people who know a lot about the business. Actually, one of the guys, Pete, he worked in the and lived in the UK for a year and a bit, a year and a half. He did go for 3 months. He was like 18 months. It just is what it is. And again, business doesn't collapse around you. It's an obligation. It's what you should do. And I've got a lot of long service leave, which I haven't used yet. So it's like all things. You think it's going to be terrible, but once it starts to roll in, it's just part of doing business. People in Japan don't want to take the allotted holidays they have because you put a burden on your co-workers by doing so. I think we did implement a policy that they must take holiday. Like, you have to take just to use it.
What a terrible rule.
If everyone takes holidays, then everyone helps everyone else out, and then it's even again. The burden's shared by everyone. That way you just kind of try and use that time and enjoy a bit of life.
皆さんと働き方について話している中、
ある言葉をよく耳にしました。
So normally like an hour lunch break?
It's very fluid when people go...
Fluid. 流動的。決まった形にはまらず、周りからの圧力にも柔軟。
Don't you eat at 11 o'clock?
I eat 11. I eat around 11.
Oh, late lunch today, sorry.
Oh, it's dinner, it's dinner.
What time does everyone come into the office?
Very fluid.
These types of jobs are fluid, so you have some flexibility of when you start, some flexibility of when you finish, and you manage around your own life, which is really important. Your family or just anything else you want to do in your life. Some flexibility is good.
Right.
I think that's what all of the people need and are asking for. So everything's facilitated with platforms and communication, so you don't always all need to be in the same place at the same time.
My partner, she also works in the business. We had kids while we had the business. And I think that's kind of part of it too, is creating an environment for me is where I'd want to work in. That opportunity should be kind of given to everybody. You can't just go, I'll be in my little ivory tower and live a certain lifestyle. It's got to be shared.
一人一人のライフスタイルに合わせたフルイドな働き方。働く上での負担もフレキシビリティもみんなで平等にシェアする。だからこそバランスが取れて成り立つんだなと感じました。ランチ後はコファウンダーのお二人に働き方についていろいろとお話しいただきました。
How it started was initially for me was having some beers after work at National Australia Bank where I used to work, talking about some of the issues and problems we're having with the technology that we're having at the time. So that kind of resulted in thinking about what to do next. And then spent New Year's Eve with Justin down the coast. And we were chatting on the beach about this particular problem and Justin said, well, I can help you out with that.
Do you actually remember saying it?
Do you regret it?
No, I don't.
What's the company culture like?
Well, you're asking the wrong people, you see, because we'll tell you it's
what
great.
Do you think it is?
The first thing you notice, we don't wear suits, so that level of formality has never been there. I think we've always fostered a company that we obviously work hard, but we take time for people and we take time out as a team as well to bond the team.
Yeah, I mean that could be bowling, it could be playing darts, it could be a picnic in the park, it doesn't really matter, but it's something that takes people out of this environment and lets them just be together as people and have a bit of fun. And I think that kind of is the whole, all of Yellowfin is about limiting formality, limiting hierarchy, and allowing people to be the best that they can be within this environment.
And you have branches outside of Melbourne.
Yep.
Is the culture very different at each of those branches?
Because again, they're located in a particular country, you're going to have their own culture, which will have a big impact on how people work and feel. But there are certain things, like we talked about in Japan, where we really want the Japanese team to take holidays, as a good example. You know, because we think that you should take time off, you should enjoy your life. Those are the types of things that we try to push down. We've had a long history, and I love the Japanese team. I think the biggest difference is the feeling of obligation that the Japanese team has to our customer base is very, very different to the feeling of obligation that exists here. My favorite Japanese word is maybe. Not yes or no, but maybe. You hear maybe a lot. I think the way in which we communicate is very transparent. As Australians, we're much more direct versus the Japanese way, which is maybe, you know, and slowly around the sides. The Japan office and working, originally they were a distributor of ours. So working with that team, I think, taught us a lot about being a global business. Because to do well in Japan, you have to think very differently because the relationships are very different, business relationships. And so I think learning that there helped us to actually build offices in the US and the UK. And I almost argue it's harder to do your business in the US than it is in Japan. Because you think that they are the same, you think culturally we're identical, when in fact we're actually very, very different. Mm. And so you get lulled into this false sense of security that we speak the same language.
I think because we watch their TV, then we're the same. Yeah.
We are so different in so many ways, and yet because we kind of look and feel the same, you don't get that kind of hard make you think about it. The US loves process. If I want to go from one thing to the next and have a document, it's going to be very clear and concise. Whereas Australians, I think, are very good in working in ambiguity. Much, much more flexible in our approach. And I think there's a whole range of reasons which are sort of generally cultural, but that make that so.
Being in Japan, I think we always think of companies overseas having more of that freedom with like work-life balance. What is the secret to that? Taking time off, but also getting things done from a business end?
Just being organized and focusing on the right things, I think, is a really good start.
We do still work hard here. There are people, like, we both work and did work incredibly long hours to start this business. It was a lot of hours.
18 hours a day. And not just for a short period too, it was like years.
Yeah. I think the difference again is probably around the decision making. It's much faster to make a decision in an Australian company. Less people are involved, you're not looking for consensus. The amount of meetings and times it takes to move on is very compressed. So for example, selling in Japan, what I've noticed, the number of customer meetings that you go to, the number of face-to-face meetings is extraordinary compared to how we do business here. Mm. And that is what saves the time, right? It's everyone's busy. It's just the fact that we kind of move on faster as opposed to spending longer trying to do a deal or to convince people that this is the way to go, etc.
Less risk sensitive. Well, still that's a factor in every decision. But I think we're willing to make a decision based on less information sometimes and move forward. So
we're more happy to fail, having tried something, than not do it at all. And I think here there's a real respect for work-life balance, you know, which we touched on at lunch, the fact that, especially in Australia, after hours drinking and socializing with work barely happens. It's business related. So socializing was a big lunchtime thing, and that's almost disappeared now as well. Mm. So people don't feel obligated that they have to, you know, work has to be this very long part of their life.
They've
got other things to do. Yeah, yeah.
It's Friday, so 2:30.
2:30, 1.5 hours to go.
We're probably out of work mode.
That's right. And it's a beautiful day outside.
Yeah, which more reason to.
Yeah, exactly right.
But still, as business owners, we're always thinking about the business at some level.
Even if you're not like sitting at a desk doing it, your mind's always.
Exactly.
Did you take time off when you had your kids?
I did take a couple of weeks off. As I told you earlier, I kind of do the morning runs and my wife does the evenings. If the kids are crazy in the morning, I'm a little bit late.
That's okay.
Most mornings. Those have been a long time, grown up and had kids while we were working here, so we've all had that kind of same environment, which has been good. So we all know when our kids are on the phone or on the meetings.
Yeah.
See them running through.
リラックスしている社員の皆さんの姿を見て、私までビーズクッションでゆったり。
Now, do you need another drink?
I'm good. これまだ5時前だから。
4時50分。
Alright guys, oh my gosh, it is 5 o'clock. もう5時過ぎちゃいました。10時から私たち来てますけど、すごい楽しかったです。
いや、そう言っていただけてありがたいです。
ね、私はもうね、YouTube 始めてから8年ぐらい経つので、会社辞めてからもう5年 ?6 年オフィスで働くとはっていうのはなんかもう覚えてないというか、だからそういう意味だとすごい新鮮でしたし、すごい温かい、ウェルカムな感じですよね、すごく居心地が。良かったです。
この会社特にカジュアルだと思うんですよ。でも私他で働いたことがないので何とも言えないですけど、
結構 IT テック系だとなんかそのインテリアでその面白さを結構出しているところも多いと思うんですけど、それよりもなんか人でこの環境が作られている感じがしました。すごいリラックスしてます。
家みたい。
家みたい。
でもこれがあの社長が作りたかった環境なので、家にいるみたいにみんなリラックスして、まあ楽しみに働きに来れる場所。
サザエさん見てても悲しくなんないわけですね。
まあでも一応ね、
まあ、それは少なからずあるんじゃない。
少なからずそれはありますよ、さすがに。
一人一人が自分にフィットしたような働き方をできる環境、もちろんオーストラリアの会社が全部こうかというとそうじゃないし、日本でももちろんいろんな会社があるし、まあ、特に今って働き方が変わってきているので最先端なところもあればまだちょっと追いついてないところもあったり、一つの例としてすごいフレキシブルな働き方をしている会社をちょっと覗かせていただきました。なので本当にありがとうございました。メルボルンの会社の中見れて面白かったと思ったらぜひいいねを押してください。 Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. A huge thanks to everyone at Yellowfin. A huge thanks to Yuka for making this happen. And we will see you guys again soon. Bye.
社長さんが来たよ。You got a new employee.
Coding monkey.
He's my boss.
Yeah.
Great guy. Best coder. Thank you.
Thank you. It was nice to meet you.
Great to meet you.
Thanks for organizing, Yuka. Enjoy the rest of your stay in Melbourne.
Oh, thank you.
大丈夫かな? Yuka-san, 変なやつ連れてきて、首とかになんないか。